Good evening, everybody. It's 9:30 p.m. Sunday night. You're joining Logical Excess on The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Act 3. We're tying up loose ends. This is episode number 2, and we've got a lot left to do. So, we defeated Imlarith. That's right, Imlarith, and 2 out of 3 of the Crones on the last episode. So let's move forward.
I see you gather before me.
After the Battle of Kaer Morhen, the defenders licked their wounds and mourned their losses, save Ciri, who began to plan her revenge. She woke Geralt one night and urged him to travel with her to Velen, to the top of Bald Mountain, where she knew she'd find Imlarith. She had decided he had to die. Her plan proved sound. On Bald Mountain, Geralt and Ciri killed Imlarith and 2 of the Crones. Spurred by their success, they resolved to challenge Eredin.
One thing I noticed is I acquired that whirlwind attack, and I was using it on Imlarith, but I wasn't able to initiate it off of the strong attack. I was only able to initiate it off the fast attack. Although the technique claims you could initiate it with either or. I just thought that was interesting that I couldn't get it to work. I can only get it to work off of one attack.
I took on some debt. Could have been by you. I'd like to blame it on the war or human treachery, but the truth is, I've got my own thick skull to blame. I'd rather not dwell on it, Geralt, if you don't mind.
Hey, Zoltan. See you later.
Maybe I should go ahead and talk to Dandelion, too.
For you, my friend, always.
Ran into Molly. She says hello.
Molly? Which Molly?
One you promised to show your butterfly collection to.
I don't remember that.
Ah, yes. Now I remember.
Butterfly collection? You of all people could stand to be a little more inventive.
Molly didn't need inventive. She needed attentive. Average, run-of-the-mill girl. Give her a smile. Notice her shoes. Let her chat about them a bit. And she'd turn into a wellspring of passion.
Got a portrait of Hierarch Himmelfort I'm willing to part with. Want it?
Yes! Those halfling painters. This one of theirs? Wonderful! I put this up at the Rosemary Time. It'll make those Temple Guard inspections so much easier.
You and Priscilla meet.
Huh. It was at the court of Duke Harold, the annual balladry contest. We faced off.
Who won?
Well, I don't remember.
I bet. probably lost and you don't want to admit it.
Actually, she'd caught my eye, so I let her win. I was counting on getting a prize after the contest.
And did you?
That, my friend, is not your concern.
Gotta tell me, how'd you wind up owning this establishment?
You'll never believe this. I inherited it from none other than Alonzo Wiley. Poor son senior himself.
You're right. I don't believe it.
Alonzo ruled the local underworld with an iron fist. But deep down, he was a romantic, pure as they come. This place is one of the reasons his son's not my biggest fan. See, Cyprian Jr., that is, wanted to make this a brothel. But the Rosemary went to me, and I planned to turn it into the most elegant venue in town. A den of art and culture.
Really, dude. High art or high culture, because this looks like basically a brothel house.
See you, Dandelion.
The House of Ill Repute. But you know what? If this is a freedom point... I've got some other things to do. And right here in Novigrad, no less. Jeez. Yeah, let's go ahead and Erston.
Where are you going?
Freaking troll, man. Well, there it is.
Stay out of my way. Crawl back under your rock.
Other thing I want to remind myself just out loud is that I need to find a I need to find a merchant who sells cherry cordial and what was the other one? Mandrake? Something Mandrake. So I can make the white gold that I need to finish the superior potion recipes that I have. that's why I never found this.
Might want to look around some.
Feline armor, feline gauntlets, trousers, boots, the whole shebang, pretty much. Geralt found all the caches marked on the map and recovered the crafting schematics contained therein. With these in hand, he could add life-saving improvements to his combat gear. He did not know how many more such caches remained undiscovered in the world, but hoped one day he would have the chance to find more. And oh yeah, we got plenty. I'm level 30 now, so let's see what I can handle. The Tower Out of Nowheres and Missing Brother. Nearest quick travel post. Okay.
Wonderful. I serve the eternal fire.
Your very presence is an affront to the eternal fire. Greetings, Ibeer.
Greetings, Geralt. How might I be of help?
What do you have on offer?
Sell that. It's not... Mahakamon trousers. I'll never wear that, I'm sure. Let's repair our gear. Okay, so we have Feline Silver Sword Superior. Was it a dark iron ingot that I needed? Dark steel ingot.
So long.
Now I need to go to... You go to Velen. Before we go to Velen, let's see what we need to concoct this brew. Allspice. Mandrake cordial. This is going to be like a wild hunt. I mean, like a little wild hunt, literally. Because I don't know who's going to have this. really. It's kind of a shot in the dark. I would say Kira might have it, but I don't think Kyra Metz. I don't think she's... I don't know where she is anymore. I don't think she's in Velen. And she's not at Kaer Morhen. She's with Eskel. See if this blacksmith can do anything.
Need something sharpened, reforged.
Like you to craft something for me. Think you can?
He's a journeyman blacksmith, so maybe. Not a blacksmith. I need an armorsmith.
So long.
Welcome. Welcome.
What have you got there? So long.
Okay, that's Vimy Vivaldi. Crap, here's Nurgle.
Welcome.
What have you got there?
All right.
So long.
The great Erasmus Bagelman Memorial Study.
Whosoever conceals a mage in their homes shall burn alongside him or her.
Not swords.
Willing to craft something for me?
Thank you. dimeridium plate. I'm not sure what pinning really does. Like, it says it will show up in the shop panel, but what? I don't know. Like, for example, formula diagram will now appear in shop panel. I just don't get it. I really don't. Because it looks like it doesn't show up at all. So there we go. Now all I need to get is some mandrake cordial.
So long.
Let's check out this new feline gear. What did I have on my silver sword? I have bleeding, stagger, and freeze. I need a freeze. Axie and Igni. I don't think I have any Axie glyphs. Oh, I do. Ard, Igni, Axie, Quinn. Ard, Igni, Axie, Quinn. So I need a Yeardon. Damn, is that all the signs? Ard, Igni, Axie, Quinn. Yeah, that is all the signs, but all right. So I can add more. I can beef up Quinn. See if we can get a Mandrake cordial here.
Welcome.
I haven't played this guy in
Gwent. What do you got there?
Not a damn thing.
For a few rounds of Gwent?
I'm pretty sure I played this dude. Oh, jeez.
creatures who fled Venom. On your way.
This Mandrake cordial is going to be a pain in the rear to find. I wonder if I should just go to Skellige and maybe find a barkeep there that actually has it. Might be better use of my time.
Geralt had to face Aradin, but could only hope to beat him with the help of friends. The Wild Hunt could be defeated with exceptionally powerful magic, so Triss and Yen set out to reconvene the Lodge of Sorceresses. Avalach, too, began to lay plans of his own.
Let's hope there's a freaking innkeep on this island.
Yourself.
You too, buddy.
Greetings, stranger.
What are you offering?
I need Mandrake cordial, bro. But I'll take those cards, though.
Take care.
outside.
Angel, cease your intrusion. Leave at once. Failure to leave when summoned. Intruder neutralization commence.
Wind whipped to rain better, Geralt stumbled into a small village on the coast of Onskellig. The foul weather, he learned, had cursed the spot ever since a mysterious tower appeared one morning out of thin air, as if placed by an invisible giant's hand. Intrigued, Geralt decided to investigate, and here I am about to get attacked by a freaking golem.
Show me what you got.
Probably greeted them too.
All right, bro.
Finally, someone's come to free me. And a famous witcher at that. Thank the gods. I'm damned lucky you happen to be in Kavir. Was it King Tancred who sent you, or the Society of Magic?
Neither, and we're not in Kavir. We're in Skellige. Local folk hired me. See, your towers brought a massive storm to their island.
We're in Skellige. So we've teleported. Oh, this is much worse than I thought.
Let me guess. You lost control of the golem. Imprisoned you here, then attacked me.
My, no, that's not it at all. The golems are but one of the tower's defenses, part of its defensive regulatory magicon.
What?
A defensive system. Magic. Ensuring only the tower's owner will use it. When it detects an intruder, it locks down all the rooms, denies access.
And since neither of us is the tower's owner, the golem attacked me and you're stuck behind bars.
Huh.
How do we evade its other charming features?
We must deactivate the defensive regulatory magicon. The tower's prior owner wrote a treatise about removing such defenses. Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire.
There must be a copy in the tower. Find it, please. With it in hand, I can try to circumvent the security measures, send you home and take the tower back to Kavir.
You clearly know who I am. I don't even know your name.
Seago Bunce, mage and sorcerer in residence at the court of Pont Vanis. This tower was to be my new home. Bought it at an auction, you see.
A tower at an auction?
It belonged to Gottfried Stamfeld, a mage of some renown. When he passed on, his heirs auctioned the edifice off. They were all wary, repulsed. None dared see what Uncle Godfrey kept in his coloured jars. If it was their contents that had stripped him of his sense of smell and taken his left eye, they put the tower on the block, along with all it contained. The price was unbeatable. I couldn't resist.
The corpses over there. Folk from the village nearby, right?
They came in a few days past. I was surprised to see their garb. But it just never entered my mind we might be in Skellige. There were just a few, led by a druid. The tower warned them. They failed to heed.
Folk on Skellige usually laugh in the face of warnings. If the tower had asked nicely, then offered them a horn of mead, they might have left then. Seen my share of wonders. But a tower that teleports itself?
Yeah.
That's something new.
This defensive regulatory magicon. I tried to access it. Must have heard. Initiated some evacuation sequence. That opened the portal and jettisoned us through to Skellige. This, in turn, naturally generated electromagnetic disturbances. Hence the storm.
Storm I promised to dispel.
Then you must find Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire.
We'll find it. Find it.
Time to get out of here and send this tower home. Where do I look for Gottfried's treaties? Any ideas?
The library might be a logical place to start. The key should be in the laboratory.
Where's that?
As you enter the room opposite, you'll see the laboratory to your left. The library straight ahead. But remember, you're an intruder. The tower is certain to want to stop you. Make things difficult at the least.
We'll see who breaks first.
Use the spell. Try to smash that barrier.
Osvayu, Iferis, Akripiat.
An intruder. Akripiat's countermeasures.
Really? A cow, really? What is that, like a nod to Diablo? Somebody in here? Black unicorn.
Ah.
Is it this cow that's making this noise?
Intruder in library. Collection integrity compromised.
Who's who among Kaviri sorcerers? Gottfried's Omni-opening grimoire.
Commencing annihilation.
Damn tower wants to gas me.
GOG, for good old games.
Isn't it? Looks like he suffocated. Horrible way to die. Intersections and geomantic lines. Not what I'm looking for.
Behind the Great Veil, of the many demons which reside in the Outer Spheres, hims are among the most dangerous. Other demons usually must take on concrete living form, be it of man or beast. Hims, on the other hand, appear in our world in their own immaterial form, which is invisible to all save their chosen victim. Hims feed on fear, regret, a sense of guilt, and a word on negative emotions, and since they are eternally hungry, they provoke these emotions in the humans they torment. These demons cannot be exorcised. A hymn takes as a victim is lost and will inevitably succumb to madness and then death. Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire, the Defensive Regulatory Magicon, or DRM for short, belongs to the above-mentioned group of the longest-lasting, most effective, and hardest-to-break defensive mechanisms. In order to recognize the individual administering it, it makes use of a portal mounted at the entrance of the area it is defend. This portal passes streams of magical energy through the body of the person entering and can, in the blink of an eye, determine if this person has the corporal signature eyeball structure included of the entitled administrator. As a result, the only unauthorized individuals that can possibly hope to enter are mimics. DRM thus makes for an extremely effective and near unbreakable security measure, but you are in luck, for you hold in your hands the key to bypassing it. Namely, the present tome, Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire, or GOG, or GOG for short. In the pages to follow, you will find innumerable methods for deactivating the DRM, or even better, bypassing it altogether.
Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire. It's a treatise.
Gotcha. Be right back.
I do have the tome.
Find the tome.
This it?
It is indeed. Now, back away a bit. I must deactivate the barrier.
Wait, he could have deactivated it the whole time?
Isolation chamber open. Disturbing indications of freedom.
There, at last.
Looked easy.
The hardest part is yet to come. We must reach the heart of the tower and cast a deactivating spell. The tower will surely do everything in its power to stop us.
Lead the way.
We must go to the central chamber. Try to power down the security measures. The defensive regulatory magic on the reactor. Be on your guard. Or by you, if it is at the yacht.
Intruder detected.
Arik Sterba.
Encroachment detected.
Gottfried's treatise proved highly useful. It's over. Had you not arrived, I'd still be in that cage, surely. It's a trifle, but take it, please. Proof of my gratitude.
Thanks. Though I'd be more than satisfied if you calmed that storm, then took this tower somewhere else.
Consider it done. And should you ever visit Kavir, do stop by Pomvanis. Aburagi. Baratheon!
Wait, what are you doing?
Not this way, the door!
The tower, as one might have predicted, was endowed with magic. To be precise, it was equipped with a defensive regulatory magicon, a mystical apparatus that treated every entrant save the tower's original owner as a dangerous intruder. That is why it had locked Sego Bunce, the Kaviri mage, who had purchased the tower at auction in a cell inside his new property. It tried to do the same with Geralt, but to a determined witcher, a tower full of magic trickery is no obstacle. Following Sego's instructions, Geralt found a tome in the depths of the library entitled Gottfried's Omni-Opening Grimoire. He and the mage used the secrets contained within to disable the tower's defenses. Once free, Sego burst with gratitude, rewarded Geralt generously, I hope, for the Witcher never said exactly how, transported him in a flash to the village where it all started, well, to be precise, to the bay off the coast from the village. Then whisked the tower away for good. Once it was gone, all that remained of the storm were a few puddles and scattered clouds in the otherwise bright and sunny sky. The gathered villagers went wild with joy and showered Geralt with well-deserved thanks. Not quite. So let's meet up with these villagers.
You're alive! And in one piece!
One soaking wet piece.
Will you teach me to fly?
Another time, maybe.
Never seen such marvels in me life. Boom, flash. Tower disappeared, and you was falling from the sky. And a storm. Gone in an instant.
Now, didn't I tell you? It's what a witcher we needed. Hey, can't do better than an expert. And expert work deserves a fitting reward.
Always knew Onskelligers were honest folk.
Hey, well, if you ever come through here again, stop in. You'll be welcomed with open arms.
Thanks. Farewell.
Wait, Witcher. Did you happen to see me brother in there? Farn's his name. He went in with the druid and a few other lads.
Didn't find anyone else inside.
I found your friends. All dead, unfortunately. Sorry.
Told him not to go. But he wanted glory.
Let's go home, Njal. No point standing here. Farewell, Witcher. Thanks again for helping.
I guess I might as well be honest, you know? Geez, I'm about to level again already. Okay, let's go to Boxholm and find the Silver Sword.
Couldn't help overhearing your conversation. Trial of the Path. What is it?
An age-old Onskellig tradition. Young men must complete the path. Only then do they turn true warriors.
So what's this path like?
Old Gunnar can tell you all you want to know about the Path of Warriors. He's the one leads the ritual.
Hmm.
Lives at the foot of Mount Ardaclove.
That's where I grew up. Ow. Don't want no stinky husband.
Oh!
During his stay in Skellige, Geralt learned of something called the Path of Warriors. This was an obstacle-strewn route. Locals believed each self-respecting warrior must travel. Geralt knew if he managed to traverse the infamously difficult path, he would earn respect and recognition throughout the Isles. We'll come back to that. We will come back to that. Because one thing, we're not going to get any XP off of it. It's too low level.
found some.
Where the heck am I? This does seem familiar. I think this is it. Geralt found all the caches marked on the map and recovered the crafting schematics contained therein. With these in hand, he could add life-saving improvements to his combat gear. He did not know how many more such caches remained undiscovered in the world, but hoped one day he would have the chance to find more. Oh, we will, my friend. We will.
ugly bastard.
There it is. I think that's it here at Skelliger. Well, we've got the Path of Warriors to do.
A warrior with two blades. One's more than enough for any who lose head of fate.
I don't know you. You don't know me. So what's your problem?
These isles were ours alone once. No foreigner dared set foot here. And if they did, they'd not return home. The good days, those.
Definitely not for those unlucky enough to land here. You, Gunner?
Who's asking? And why?
I want to travel the Path of Warriors.
No outlanders ever dared. But if you've had your fill of life, go on, try.
What do I do?
Hard's got two offshoots. One leads into mountain peaks, the other into the bowels of the earth. Traverse both, and you'll have proved your valor.
Tell me about the mountain path.
It leads along the crest of Mount Ardic Clove. You'll find a crimson shawl at the peak. Bring that back as proof you've reached the path's end.
Doesn't sound like much of a challenge.
Clear you've not spent much time in our mountains.
Can you tell me more about the underground path? Is it a cave of some sort?
Aye, but the corridors leading to it are flooded. No continentals ever managed to swim them. Takes training since youth. A lot of diving after pearls.
We'll see about that. What else?
At the cavern's end, a surprise awaits. Take what you find there, bring it to me.
A surprise? What kind?
You'll see. So long as you get to the end. So long as the harpies don't get you.
Well, I'm not scared to try.
Not just foreign, but dumb too. Well, no cure in that. Well, run to the top of Mount Ardiclove. Grab the crimson shawl. Then reach the cave. At its end, you'll find something I'm not about to describe. On you go then, show the world what you're worth.
Yeah, this might be a little bit.
Brand those swords, but I prefer me trusty axe.
do to complete the Path of Warriors? Remind me.
Eager to walk the path, but don't remember what he's to do. Climb to the top of Mount Ardaclove, retrieve the Crimson Shawl. Then reach the cavern at whose end you'll find something I will not describe. Bring me that with the shawl.
Okay.
Best way to go.
Right, if a weak arm swinging at eight.
Why does it seem like I've done this already?
The white-haired one goes to his death.
foreigners ever completed the Path of Warriors.
First time for everything.
Some only learn from their mistakes. Thing is, in Skellige, mistakes usually cost you your life.
Place of power.
What now, you piece of filth?
Yeah, I will fall to my death there for sure. At least I think I will.
pleasant place.
Swords, but I prefer me trusty axe.
You bring news?
Path of yours wasn't easy, but I managed to get to the end. Here's proof.
First Outlander to complete the trial. A feat worthy of respect. I'll make sure news of your deeds spreads across the Five Isles.
Best blade's not worth shining a weak arm swinging at.
What is this? Oh, okay, the arena. The Witcher overcame all obstacles along the path and made it to the end. From then on, even the proudest Skellig of Wars have treated him with respect. And this is a good place to end. We're approaching the 2-hour mark, so that means I've streamed twice today. One for an hour and a half earlier today, and now for 2 hours. And we're doing well tying up these loose ends, but it looks like the remaining quests we have are in Novigrad, which should make things life simpler, because that's right in line with where the main quest is. I'm not sure about completing the collection of Gwent cards. I think that's going to be a little little difficult because that's going to require me basically traveling all over the freaking world trying to find any sort of merchant that I did not play Gwent with. And yeah, that's just very tedious. So I doubt I'll complete that on this playthrough. But anyways, I'll go ahead and end it here. This has been episode number 2 in Tying Up Loose Ends, Act 3, Witcher 3 Wild Hunt playthrough, and this is going to be it for the weekend. Tomorrow the work week starts, and so won't be able to stream again until next weekend. Alrighty, guys. Peace.